Who gives this woman to be married? Good afternoon, and welcome to the celebration. You may be seated. Jump in the gun. I've done this 4 times, and I've failed to say it every time. Good afternoon, and welcome to the celebration of the joining of two souls, Keela and Sean, that will be bound to each other for the rest of their lives. We kindly ask that you do put away your phones and enjoy this moment, present in the moment. This is important to the bride and groom, and we ask that you please respect their wishes. First and foremost, Keela and Sean would like to thank everyone for attending, for your support, and most of all, for the love that you've poured into their lives. Each person here has touched their life in a profound way, and they are eternally grateful. So where do we begin? Deciding what to say about a couple during a wedding is no easy task, especially when you're officiating your brother's wedding. No pressure. So let's just start at the beginning. Keela was born, raised, and continues to live in Brevard County, and her love for animals has been apparent since day one. While for years she has continuously said, no more animals, her collection has yet to stop. And fortunately for all, she added Shawnee Boy to the group. Though I do imagine he's the most difficult of them all to take care of.
True.
Keela has been an amazing mother and an emotional rock to her daughter, Ayla, who is now gaining a new father figure. And Ayla, trust me, Sean loves you like you are his biological daughter. He's always so proud when he speaks of you, and I've never seen him take to a child so quickly. He can sometimes have short patience, especially with kids and adults and bad drivers and people who don't pay attention and Gators fans. That's getting a bit off track. But this has never seemed to be the case with you. All of us here are thrilled to officially see this family become an official family. Now, Sean is from Huntsville, Alabama, so we're lucky that Keela is up here and not Lauren. He's the youngest of 4 boys. He's the youngest of 4, and boy, did he catch hell. Growing up with Stratner ain't easy. In Sean's youth, he collapsed on the baseball field and was found to have a major heart issue that would send his beats per minute north of 240. This medical issue could have truly taken Sean's life. But he, by what some would say a miracle, fully recovered, never had another issue, and never looked back. This miracle in part occurred so that the miracle that we are witnessing today could occur. And I promise you, Sean, getting married is a miracle. The story of when the couple before you first met begins like so many romantic stories before you, at work. Keela and Sean met when he began working at Sorensen Moving and Storage, and Keela worked for Health First, who utilized their services, as she continues to do to this day. She was instantly attracted to Keela.
Oh,
instantly attracted to Keela, though I'm not sure that initially the feeling was reciprocated. Sean had asked Keela out several times with no success, so he started to back off a little bit. Like so many women, as soon as it looked like she might not have a chance with Sean any longer, she decided she was interested. She wanted what she could no longer have. She finally agreed to go out with Sean, and that's all she wrote. As they dated, it became clear this was not a fling, but this was a forever thing. The way Sean immediately took on a father role with Ayla really helped cement her feelings for him. Coming into a relationship when your partner has a child is not easy. But for Sean, this was his destiny. But it's not always the big things in life that really let you know that you've met your match. But the daily reminders, the daily occurrences, the daily interactions that we share in private, that can show the heart everything that it needs to know. Keela shared a story about the time she'd been asking Sean for help remodeling the kitchen. It was a project she'd wanted to complete for quite some time, but Sean was really not confident in her craftsmanship. What a hater. Now, this may not yet seem like a story that would scream, "Wow, we're meant to be." But it's what happened next that filled Kayla's heart with love. Sean had come home from work, and Keela had half the kitchen ripped apart. She could no longer wait. Now, anyone that knows Sean knows this really could have gone two ways. So Sean walks in, goes to the bedroom, changes his clothes, and without any hesitation, he began helping rip the 2x4s out of the ceiling. No fuss, no hassle, just support for the woman he loves. It is in these moments when we look at our partners and we understand the love that they have for us. These are the small moments that are not to be overlooked or underestimated. These are the moments that we will cherish forever. Now, by the time they got engaged, Keela had no doubt that Sean was the man she wanted to spend the rest of her days with. But the way Sean proposed to her left her with no doubt. Keela, Ayla, and Sean took a trip to Lake Tahoe to see our brother Thomas. Tahoe. It was a trip filled with skiing, hiking, going to the lake, eating, and creating memories with some of the closest people in their lives. Sean had planned on a snowmobile trip that took them to the top of the mountain. It had been blizzarding for the last few days. The entire basin was coated in fresh white powder that sparkled in the sunlight. When everyone was taking photos, Sean approached Ayla with a ring box, dropped to a knee, and professed his love for her mother and asked for her permission to take Keela's hand. Ayla gave a resounding yes. Sean then turned to Keela and asked for her hand. It was a perfect moment. They all hugged and I'm sure shed a tear or two. Keela knew at this moment she had her perfect family. Her heart was full. Only men with character move like this, and Sean has that in spades, which I'm sure we're gonna play tonight. Now for Sean, his moment of confidence fell into place the only way that it could. The aftermath of dealing with the strap hat. Yeah. Keela and Sean hosted us for our first celebration of Thanksgiving. While Keela knew us all a little bit, and Sean had certainly forewarned her, the only way you ever really get to know us is until you put us all together and watch what happens. All you can do is sit back. So as usual, we partied hard, we watched FSU play Miami, and all the cursing that goes with that. and partied late into the night. My wife tracked poop through their house. Our new dog wouldn't stop jumping on their couch. We were a bit loud, a bit drunk, and frankly, took over. All in all, a mild night for the strap. For Keila, I can imagine that this was a shock to the system. And I know Sean was worried about how she might react. But through it all, Keila kept a smile. To Sean's surprise, there were no freakouts, no overreactions, no harassing, just a girl doing whatever she could to make sure her boyfriend's family had the best Thanksgiving that they possibly could, and that everyone was taken care of all night. To Sean, this was it. He had found his soulmate. He found his partner in crime. And he had found the woman that could handle the strap hat. God bless her. Keila and Sean's story is one of patience, commitment, and a balance of two very different personalities that created one beautiful love. We can all learn from them. And it is our duty as family and friends to continue to support and inspire them as they have inspired us through their journey as husband and wife. Now, Keila and Sean have written their vows, which they will share with each other now.
Sean, of all the people you've met on your journey and of all the places you've been, somehow, in some way, you ended up here with me. It's the most powerful and humbling fact that I can accept. I used to think that we met by chance, but now I know without a doubt the universe put you in front of me because we were meant to spend our lives together. You have filled my life with joy and have given me a sense of peace that I have never known. You're my best friend, my biggest supporter, and the best Eminem rapper I've ever known. Although today marks the rest of our lives, I know it will not be enough time with you. I will not take our time together for granted, and because words cannot do it, I promise to show you for the rest of my life how much I love you. I promise to encourage you to follow your dreams. I promise to make you laugh when you're taking yourself too seriously. I promise to hold your hand through the good times and the bad times. I promise to be loyal and faithful and to put you before all else. I promise to never stop saying no more animals. Although, I know you wish I would. And I promise that when we're old and gray, we will look back on our lives together and have no regrets. From this day forward, you will never walk alone.
Keila, I remember the first time I heard your voice. We are complete strangers, and you called me frantically making sure my team had a move on the schedule for your team. And I remember thinking to myself, she sounds hot. My suspicions were correct, and you were hot. And you look absolutely gorgeous tonight. All silliness aside, I'm so happy to be standing before you today, about to call you my wife. I have quite a few flaws, an abundance of quirks, and a crazy family, to say the least. I cannot promise you to be a perfect husband or father. but I do promise to always learn from my mistakes, to try to be a better man for you and Ayla. To love and to care for you on your brightest days and your darkest nights. You're the perfect balance to all my imperfections. You and Ayla have made me a better man than I had ever thought I could become. Ayla, I'm so grateful to be a part of your life, and I'm so proud to call you my daughter. I promise to be the father that you've always deserved, to be there for you wherever and whenever you need me. I love you so much. Keila, Ayla, we have such an exciting life ahead of us, and I wouldn't trade that for the world. I love you both with all my heart, now and forever.
Sean, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a daily reminder of my love for you.
As a daily reminder of my love for you.
And as a representation of my eternal commitment.
And as a representation of my eternal commitment.
Keila, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a daily reminder of my love for you.
As a daily reminder of my love for you.
And as a representation of my eternal commitment.
And as a representation of my eternal
commitment. Sean, do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Keila, do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband? By the power of the love of all the witnesses here in an online officiant process, I now pronounce you man and wife. Sean, you may kiss your bride. Yeah.